I'm currently teaching my dog place command. Today I corrected him with a remote collar when he got off and he went into his cage, which is right next to his place, and started shaking. What do I do?
Well, number one, you just started doing place. Informational purposes, Ashley. Ashley asked the question, right? We don't tell our dogs no or give a correction for an obedience command until we've done 350 to 400 repetitions. No corrections at all. As much as I talk about corrections, as much as I talk about punishments, when it comes to training obedience, 350 to 400 repetitions before the dog ever hears no with a consequence. So you possibly you correct the dog too soon. Don't worry, you didn't fuck it up. Number one, close the crate door. Number two, start again. And watch our video on the CS and NCS of how you train your dog place, but there's massive amounts of repetitions before you go to no with a correction. Next.
Going live.
Now we're live. Hey everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. There's the lovely Joelle. How are you? We're on the road right now. We're in Leander, Texas. We're about an hour outside. I was an hour outside of Austin, and we were just finished up a two-day seminar, Jeff Gellman seminars, and today we had some privates. And we're at our host house, Paul, and we just had a wonderful dinner. And this, the way the show works is this: it's a 90-minute show. It's a Q&A show, and so. Three different components I'll talk about tonight. The What Would Jeff Do show, which is a Q&A show, which you'll notice the line of questioning people are saying, how do I stop, how do I stop, how do I stop? So the answers are usually based on punishments. So you don't use reward to stop an unwanted behavior, so you'll hear that. Also, we just finished up Jeff Gellman seminars. Jeff Gellman seminars, which is our two-day seminar. We do 28 around the world. We're actually gonna be in six different countries next year in 2020. We just actually announced Manchester, England, and we're also going to be in Scotland, along with New Zealand, Australia, Singapore, Canada. We have not announced Canada dates yet. We're still looking for some locations in Canada, and then obviously the United States as well, which is where we're based. Excuse me. I've been fighting off of an intense sickness for about 3 or 4 days.
Intense sickness.
3 or 4 days. Okay.
It's called a man cold.
I was just going to say, it's not a man cold at all, and I've got...
Intense sickness. I like that label.
And then also at the training center, I might have to fucking just, I might cough so much you might have to do the show, so watch yourself there, sister. And then at the training center, which the training center is mostly primarily board and training, that's based in Providence, Rhode Island. You can go to solidcaninetraining.com. The training center is all, believe it or not, when a dog comes in, even with the worst behaviors, it's mostly reward-based training. And I just specify that because for some reason, people think all we do is bonk dogs, and that's maybe, I don't know, 3 minutes out of a long day. So there's a lot of other minutes that we're not. So here we go with the questions. Next.
Michelle had another beautiful walk with my reactive dog. We encountered a gas remote control car. Sure, no problem. We can walk right past that, and so we did 3 times.
Wow.
Woohoo! Good job, Michelle.
Michelle, congratulations. Next.
CR, happy Monday, guys. I was wanting info on how you help other people's businesses grow. Is it just dog training, or how does it work exactly?
No. You can hire me as a consultant. So you can do a Skype with me. And if you go to solidcaninetraining.com, you can hire me as a consultant to help your business grow, mostly service-oriented businesses. Also, Joelle is also doing Skypes on social media. So we can help you in a lot of different ways. Next.
Michelle, the only thing I'd like to improve is him head bumping the side of my leg after seeing something that would otherwise make him reactive.
So right now, you've got to say, okay, he's not reacting, but he's head bumping my leg. So what you can start doing is take the leash, if he walks on your left-hand side, and pop to the left, or just use your leg. Also, if he's walking a little bit behind you, he can't head bump you. So you can start taking that heel, get him a little bit behind you. You do that through spatial pressure. Next.
CR, my dog is always very hyper and go, go, go. Is exercise and mental stimulation the answer?
No, not necessarily. Yes, your dog needs exercise. Yes, as far as what's mental stimulation, that could be just training in general. Teach the art of doing nothing as well. People are not putting enough emphasis on that. I'm a huge advocate of exercise, but let's look at our lives. You don't have 10 hours a day to exercise your dog, 8 hours a day, 4 hours a day. You just don't. Some people only have an hour a day, which actually is enough. What you're gonna do is teach duration downs and duration place. So when you're hanging out, like right now, when we're back in Providence, we have five dogs laying down in front of us and some to the side of us, like around us. And they're not tired, they're just told to do nothing. And these are all high drive dogs. Next.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and everyone in the chat.
Hey, Melissa, how are
Melissa,
you?
Melissa, I just got your email. It just popped up on my phone.
Nice.
Cobri, hi, Jeff, 5 months old, working line GSD. He's doing great with e-collar training on low levels, but he lunges at cars even when corrected at the highest level on the mini educator. Is this collar too weak?
Not necessarily. Your timing could be off. It also could be collar fit. It's also not about just pushing buttons. The last thing I want anybody to do is just blast your dog for a lunging behavior. There are behaviors that you would quote unquote blast your dog for. Getting up on the counter, getting in the litter box, getting in the trash, fence fighting. Those are all blastable reactions you can do. But for healing, there's an art to it. And for stopping leash reactivity, there is actually an art to it. So number one, you have to start farting. Just fart. Whenever your dog wants to lunge at a car, just fart. And your dog
will throw him off.
What your dog does is it stops looking in the car and it looks around, smells your butt, the car goes by, and then
What car?
So I would encourage you to start working on your gas. What you're gonna start doing is this is a serious show, Joelle. Okay.
Okay.
You're dropping F-bombs now too? That's my job. All right. So
I'm so tired.
Is that what this is? So you laugh your ass off and drop F-bombs when you're tired? So every show you're tired. Because you laugh every show, which is wonderful. Okay. You get so many compliments on that laugh. People are like, I wish I could bottle that laugh up. It's like, so what you're going to do is start watching our spatial pressure videos. Next.
Levi. Hey, JJ, is it Levi or Levy? Put the little pronunciation thing in the comments below.
Or ask a question.
Hey, JJ, do you find in your life or in clients at the center or seminars...
See, that one, start from the beginning.
Do you find in your life or in clients at the center or seminars that good parenting skills transfer to dog training or vice versa?
Okay. Ironically, a lot of people that are really soft for their dogs were firm with their kids. And then there's people that are unfortunately not doing the best job parenting, and I shouldn't be a judge of that, who are also struggling with their dog. I find that rules and structure and discipline goes a long way with both children and dogs. Now it's like, well, also praise and reward. That's a given. See, I don't mention that as much because that's a given. So when I say correct, reward, apply a punisher, don't forget about the rewards. It's like, that's a given. Like, a lot of people will say, well, you don't ever talk about exercise. Okay, well, yeah, I do, but that's also a given. And exercise does not eliminate unwanted behaviors. Next.
Angela, hello, I'm looking for your spatial pressure video. What would the title image look like? Did we make an official
one? I don't think we have an official one. We show that in
Chicago, that black dog that lunged at bikes. But that was like a brief little...
a brief little clip of a dog that lunged at bikes in Chicago. If you look at today on our Instagram stories, there's a two of the little cells, 15-second cells, of Joelle doing a spatial pressure exercise with one of our private one-on-ones that we had today. Joelle helped out a client, a wonderful client for that. You can see that as well. Next.
Scattered Storm says hi.
Hello, Gretchen. How are you, honey?
Michelle, Good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and Melissa. I hope Austin treated you well.
Austin has been treating us very well. Thank you.
Levi, our 11-month-old female, is trying to instigate a lot of play with our 18-month-old. He seems to be getting annoyed. Aside from creating space and getting her away from him, what else can I do?
Correct the dog. F the space. Get yourself a stockyard whip or a bonker. Say no. Stockyard whip, a little smack on the butt. Bonker, bonk, right on the head. Just tell your dog to cut it out. Next.
Abigail, have you ever run into negativity from a vet about feeding raw or even using a prong? Our vet won't let us have a prong on in the office. Really irritating.
Really?
Whoa.
Really? Okay. So time for you to find a new, for first of all, yes on both. Well, my vet wouldn't give me a hard time about a prong. But I have had vets in the past that have. Raw, my vet does not give me a hard time about raw, but yes, I've had vets in the past. So these are ex-vets, meaning they're not in my world anymore. It's like,
for a reason.
It's like, don't talk to me about training and don't talk to me about nutrition, okay? I will listen to you about medical advice, and that's it. So you can't have a prong on in the waiting room. Are they legal in your country? Really? Okay, what else? What other collars can you not have on? Are you allowed a choke chain on? Because choke chains hang dogs. Choke chains cause massive trauma to a dog's neck. When they take your dog into the back room, historically they take a slip lead. A slip lead is theoretically a hangman's noose. If you hold it up in the air, your dog could actually suffocate and die. They also have drawers in their emergency, in their surgery suites that literally will cut open, saw off, and drill through your dog. You can tell them you're uncomfortable with all those tools. So the collar that I have on is one of the nicer things that you've got in your vet practice. So how about this, vet? All those dogs that are acting like assholes in your waiting room, I'd like that fixed. Okay? Every time one of your vet techs talks to my dog in a high-pitched voice, I'd like that fixed. Hey, do you know how about my dog blows his anal glands when he gets on the scale? I'd like my dog to stop doing that. The vet needs to worry more about his business or her business and stay out of your business. Next.
One big weirdo. Went on a long run with my bulldog today. No pulling. I'm actually excited to take him on walks now. Prong collar saves the day.
Awesome. Next.
Levi. They play great, but when he isn't always in the mood and I want her to know she doesn't always get to or have to play with him, I also want to avoid a dog fight.
Right. Teach your dog the out command, meaning get out of here. We have videos on that. Next.
Troy. Prong collar saves my life. Thank you.
Prong collars are great. Next.
Kayla. Dog plays rough, not aggressive, just rough during play. But he's very vocal, barking, growl sounds. Is there a way to correct the noise level without telling him that play is bad?
I don't know how to. Well, let me refrain. I don't mind my dogs doing that at all. It's play. That's when they are allowed to do it. It sounds like my dogs are fighting, but it's play. So I don't stop it. How do you stop it? How do you stop the audible without the action? That might be a little bit challenging. Next.
Viviana, hi, I have two dogs and I want to start e-collar with them. Is two collars, one remote enough, or should I get two remotes? Love your content. Thanks.
Personal choice. Start out with one remote, two collars. You can always add another remote and program it to the two collars. Next.
Bronwyn, hi, Jeff and Joelle. You are both looking great. Hope you guys had an awesome seminar this weekend.
Thank you for the wonderful world, wonderful words. Joelle definitely looks good. Me, we can probably take a vote on that, and I don't want to know the results. Number two, we're having a fantastic time here in Texas. We went out for barbecue last night. We had leftover barbecue, which means it became salad topping for me today. That was good barbecue.
That's good.
It was good salad topping.
Chicken was good.
Next.
Jordan. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. First time catching your live, and you all are great. I took my newly adopted pup to a board and train where the trainers have been to your seminars, and they were amazing.
Awesome.
Thank
cool.
you for all your amazing content.
Mm. Just to let you know, they were probably good before my seminar. Because it's a two-day seminar. That doesn't make anybody a dog trainer. So chances are, you picked the right place. Even if they didn't go to my seminars. But thank you for the shout-out and whoever those trainers were. They're probably nice people because a lot of nice people come to my seminars. In fact, everybody that comes to my seminars is a nice person historically. Next.
Cheyenne and Zeke. Took Zeke to the Veterans Day parade. He did amazing. He ignored the dogs that lunged at him.
Yes.
The horses he'd seen for the first time ever.
Wow.
And the sirens horn on the show cars. Today was great.
Awesome. And for all my veterans out there, thank you for your service and happy Veterans Day. And I really appreciate all the men and women who have done the work they've done for this country. I appreciate that tremendously. Thank you.
Melinda, best way to begin teaching 5-month-old large pup to give young kids in the home space? Right now I use Place, but I love what I saw with the video of the dogs and little Angelo by the pool.
So I've taught my dogs out, meaning get away from things. I've always created a bubble around Angelo. And if you want to go to, by the way, if you want to see that video, you can go to Angelo's Instagram channel, which is Angelo Gellman on Instagram.
At Angelo Gellman.
At, well, don't people know that though?
You never know. So
if you, no, if you go to Instagram and you're in the search box, you just type in Angelo Gellman, you don't have to type in the at.
Whatever. You always say at.
No, you don't.
No, you, when you plug his channel, at Angelo Gellman.
No, I don't.
Go watch every video.
Except for this one, because it won't say it. So, right. Go to at, because Joelle's always right and I'm always wrong. So, at Angelo Gellman. So, what did I do with that? God, it goes so... He was just raised like that. I just raised all my dogs to stay away from my kids.
Probably just doing spatial partial stuff,
probably
not
just,
even realizing it.
Yeah, I probably didn't realize it. Like, probably just was like, said, get the fuck away from this kid. Next.
One big weirdo. My bulldog has recently started growling at the water bowl when my other dog probably is drinking growling out of it too. How do I train her to stay away from the bowl when he's drinking from it?
Teach your dog the out command, which means get out of here. Out has a lot of context. We have a video that shows how to teach your dog how to get out of there. Next.
Daniel, how much should you bonk for jumping when entering home or guests arrive?
We usually use a remote collar, a prong collar, a very firm pop. How much should you bonk? The right amount. Next.
One big weirdo. Also, I took your advice and cut my dog's back leg off. He no longer pees on his leg. Thanks, Jeff.
Awesome. So this is what I really, really like. I really like committed owners like yourself, one big weirdo. So you definitely, first place trophy of the week. Next.
Good to know it works because I'm still trying to figure out how to stop Wes from pissing on his leg.
Well, he pisses on his front right.
Yeah. That one's got to go.
So, it's got to go.
Every time. I'm surprised it's not like fluorescent yellow by now.
No.
On his nice golden Next. Oh, Kara. Meal prepping raw meals while I listen. I have been following you guys for years, since before I had my first dog. You've helped with turning my passion into hopefully a soon-to-be career. Love you guys.
Awesome. Well, let's make that a career. There's no reason why not to. There's a shortage of dog trainers out there. Next.
Melinda, the show's barely started, and Joelle's awesome laugh has made its appearance.
Yes. She laughs before the show even presses live.
I laugh all day long.
Yes, it's yes, she
like
does.
What I do.
Yeah, it really is. So we're not, did I say anything's wrong with that? Why turn that into a negative? Okay. Yeah.
I just laugh at everything.
And I love every minute of it. I know.
I can't imagine, like, not.
I can't imagine you not either. I'm spending 12 days with you this trip. It's like, if there's a day without laughter, then something's not right.
Something's wrong.
I know.
Dog Training Elite Texas, thank you so much for the seminar this weekend. My staff and I really enjoyed it and learned a lot.
Awesome.
The big takeaway was how much we underwhelm client dogs when trying to eliminate a behavior.
Good. That's a great takeaway. It was great to have you there. Next.
Levi, when going for a walk, I put both dogs in a sit. They wait for the door and me to say break. Should I use heel instead of break?
Yes, you should, because break is more of an excitement command. Heel probably is more of a not as exciting. Excuse me, next.
Levi also said, Joelle, it's Levi, like the jeans.
Nice.
Good to know. Jane Doe, this podcast is the perfect way to finish my day. Grateful for your humor and dog tips.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's great. Awesome. Wow. It's wonderful. It's wonderful to be part of anybody's day. So I appreciate that. Next.
Good dog coaching and pet care. What do you do when a potential client is potty pad training their dog and wants to continue because they don't want to have to take the dog outside but wants to board and train? I'm thinking, not my client. We teach dogs potty on command outside.
Yeah. I'm right there with you. Next.
Spuds K, is marking inappropriately, like in a store, a blastable behavior? How would you approach stopping the behavior for a covert walk-in pisser and a wheelchair user that can't really wheel and look down in time?
So if you've got a dog, you're in a wheelchair, you got a dog with you, and it freaking decides to pee in a store, yeah, that would be a high-level correction. Next.
Thad, how do you fit the Baskerville muzzle on with the prong? It seems like the muzzle pushes it down.
No.
Muzzle strap goes right above the prong.
Right. So the muzzle strap goes above the prong. The muzzle strap should be super snug. And then
right behind the ear,
and then the prong can go a little bit behind it. Next.
Ra, thanks for the training seminar in Austin. You guys enjoyed being there. I learned a lot. Well worth it and highly recommended.
Awesome. And we'll be back next November. We're not sure which weekend, weekend one or weekend two. So November of 2020, we'll be back in Austin. Next.
Levi, for raw feeding or even your own health diet, have you used or heard of bee pollen?
Mm-hmm. Yep. 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 In fact, there's a great book. This ebook. I'll start promoting this ebook soon. Next.
Scattered Storm. I had a busy weekend. Friend and I brought our dogs to an outdoor mall event. Great opportunities. We got all the comments. People get on walks packed into 2 hours, and the only one comment on how my dog didn't look happy. When I happened to be miscommunicating and overcorrecting radar in one small moment, both of our dogs did great. The dogs also had a great time.
Awesome. Proud of you, Gretch. Next.
John, thinking of offering free leash training to get more reps. Anything to be cautious about? Thanks.
No, just have fun. Just have fun. No obligation of anything in return. Don't sell. Just give. Got it? Just give. If you want more business, give. It's just the way it is. Next.
Viviana. Got my ticket last week for the San Francisco seminar. I'm so excited.
Awesome. Awesome. Proud of you.
Is that San Francisco?
That's Petaluma.
Petaluma.
That's okay. Coming up. Yeah. December.
I love that place.
Yep. We're just talking about today.
Super cool venue.
Today, we're just talking about, do we book the last Airbnb that we booked last time, which is in, oh my gosh, what's the name of the city? N? It was an N? It's 20 minutes south of Petaluma.
Sorry,
begins with an O.
Nevado.
Begins with an N.
That place was cute.
Yeah. Yeah.
That coffee place.
I know. That breakfast place. Or do we go into Petaluma and we just stay up in Petaluma because the gym's in Petaluma? We find a place in Petaluma. Maybe we should find a place on the water in downtown Petaluma where we went out to eat that one time.
Oh, that's a cute area too.
Next. I bet you there's a lot of Airbnbs in those, like, in the mill buildings there.
Probably.
That might be cute. Next.
Kara, someone asked me about helping with their aggressive Cocker Schnauzer. I don't have experience with aggression, but I thought this would be a good learning opportunity. Thoughts? I use prong and e-collar.
It's a good opportunity to get bit. So what you do is require a muzzle and tell them you'll help them on obedience. But aggression's a whole other world. It's a whole other world. You can stop your life. You know, I would be really careful with that. So muzzle the dog, work the dog on just basic obedience. So instruct them about how to run their households, how to have a schedule for the dog, training protocols for the dog, basic commands, how to hold the dog accountable, how to properly walk their dog, which is the basic commands. And then if you want to do, you can remote collar train that dog. And you can train them on how to use a bonker or a remote collar to stop all the growling. But I'd be really careful with some of that hands-on stuff when it comes to the aggression. Next.
Colleen, at what age do you recommend starting e-collar training, prong collar training for growing puppies? What are your best training tips for a barking puppy? Thank you.
The best training tips for a barking puppy is, the first one was what? What age do I start with what?
Hold on, where did it go? Starting e-collar and prong collar.
So e-collar and prong collar can be about 12 or 14 weeks old, but not for corrections. You're just conditioning the dog to it. You're layering it over your existing training, which is being done with food. As far as barking, no, bonk the dog. Next.
Ashley, I'm currently teaching my dog place command. Today I corrected him with a remote collar when he got off and he went into his cage, which is right next to his place, and started shaking. What do I do?
Well, number one, you just started doing place. Informational purposes, Ashley. Is it Ashley that asked the question, right? We don't tell our dogs no or give a correction for an obedience command until we've done 350 to 400 repetitions. No corrections at all. As much as I talk about corrections, as much as I talk about punishments, when it comes to training obedience, 350 to 400 repetitions before the dog ever hears no, with a consequence. So you possibly you correct the dog too soon. Don't worry, you didn't fuck it up. Number one, close the crate door. Number two, start again. And watch our video on the CS and NCS of how you train your dog place, but there's massive amounts of repetitions before you go to no with a correction. Next.
Ashley said, love your show, by the way.
Love you too, Ashley.
Levi, best thing to curb over arousal coming out of the crate?
You can bonk your dog or have a leash on the dog and then pop your dog into a sit. Next.
Gabe, Jeff, you need to take a vacation, buddy.
Gabe, are you saying that because
he gets sick when he hears the word.
Are you saying that because I look sick and tired? I'm leaving for Maui tomorrow. I mean, Oahu tomorrow. So I'm not going to be, well, there's 3 days off in between seminars.
You'll still be working.
Of course I'll be working, but still.
Work is fun.
Okay, people have got to understand what my passion is. I love what I do. I love what I do. So it's work.
It's true.
This whole thing about, so I do not have the philosophy of, if you do what you love, you have to never work another day in your life. That's bullshit. I work every day. It's hard. Actually, work and running a business is actually like war. And I'm no disrespect to anybody that actually fights war, but it's like chess and war. It is a battle. And in my world, it's a daily battle because of the amount of haters that I have. So, but I love what I do. I love creating content to help people. It's not I love being around dogs. Okay, I love helping people. I love helping people eliminate problems. I love giving. I really enjoy what I'm doing. So I actually don't need a vacation. I don't.
You need rest.
That's sleep. A different, right, which you don't need a vacation for.
Right.
Okay? But I love what I do with intense, intense passion. Next.
Woo! Heating up. He'll sleep on the plane, maybe.
Yeah, I will.
Levi, you said you don't allow marking. Do you mean urine or kicking up behind or both?
Definitely not urine. But hold on. Let's put this into context. If I'm off-leash hiking with my dogs and they want to piss on a couple of things and I know it's marking, I don't really care. I've owned dogs that have kicked up scent. I didn't care. But if you're a pushy, snotty, or aggressive dog, the kicking up, I'm going to stop. Why? It's just something I feel that is important to do. Like, spread your odor somewhere else, buddy. But you ain't going to do it over here. Okay? So, next.
Thomas. So true. Give, give, give. What comes back will blow your mind.
Yep, it's true. Thank you, Thomas.
So true. Good dog coaching and pet care. What is the soonest you've moved from prong to e-collar, working with Golden, who jumps, mouths, bites, leash, and other assorted shenanigans? Has a neck impervious to prong corrections, bonker effective for some behaviors, but not others. Very strong-willed dog.
Yesterday. Next.
Britt. I took your advice on slow walking. It was great. Now she puts her nose on my hand and looks at me. Last night, we did a 2-mile walk slowly. Works.
Are you home yet?
Should I work on walking a little faster over time?
So this is it. You can mix it up. You can mix it up. This is what I want you to do. Everyone's like, I can't say how many times I tell people when you're trying to master the walk, go up and down your driveway. And people are like, no, I got to get 3 miles. It's like, no, you don't. You got to get 45 minutes. You can spend 45 minutes going up and down your driveway. Slow. real slow, turn into the dog, turn away from the dog, do sits, do downs, do walkaways, meaning you walk away and you leave the dog in command, come back, pick up the leash, walk away again, come back, pick up the leash, put your dog in heel, go slow, go fast, turn right, turn left, come back, do a couple 180s that are quick. Like, and that, like, so you can do that. Well, doesn't the dog have to be tired out? That does tire them out. But also then, play chuck it, go on a run, go for a bike ride with your dog. But the training aspect though, it's that driveway routine that I just said, that's a gold mine of information for your dog. Next.
Spuds, also, do GSDs typically go through an excessively whiny stage during adolescence? Or am I doomed to forever having a nonstop slide whistle in my wake?
The answer is yes.
A slide whistle! That's the second time someone said that. Unless it was them in the last show.
The answer is yes,
yeah,
on both.
Screwed.
So I rarely ever play the breed card, except for when it comes to Malinois and some bulldogs. But we see a lot of whiny shepherds.
Yeah, they love to hear themselves.
I see a lot of whiny shepherds. But ironically, we have one whiny shepherd that I help take care of that doesn't whine around me but whines around the owner. So I think he could be stopped. So is it us or is it the dog? So Wes whines a lot around her. Wes never whines around me, ever, unless she's in the car. So, you know, does that mean, so is a dog a whining dog? That's an interesting question. Next.
Thad, with Emma's continued reactivity, aggression to dogs, is the next step an e-collar or a bonk? We are structuring the hell out of her and working her, but still, it persists.
So this is the thing. The answer is it's dog training. That's the answer. Okay, so it's all dog training. The equipment is useless unless the training behind it is effective. So I can do it with, like, a heel tap. I could do it with possibly more structure. I can do it maybe with body pressure, you know, spatial pressure. The thing is, all of these tools that we have are fantastic, wonderful tools. But you have to still know how to use them. I'm not saying you don't know how to use them, but a remote collar is a fantastic tool, not just to tell your dog no, but for also to do off-leash obedience close by and at a distance, as well as state of mind training. Next.
Lori, my 21-month-old Roddy knows place, and we practice it every day. But when we go to the vet, he refuses to place on the scale. He places on an elevated place board, but scale scares the bejesus out of him.
Right. So don't call it place. Call it get the fuck up on the scale. And use leash pressure and role play the hell out of it. Next.
Midgie, hello from your formerly too shy to say hi fan. Just saw the notification for the live and got super happy to be able to catch a live one. Super grateful for all you guys do.
Midgie, I'm really happy that you're not so shy anymore.
Awesome.
Thank you. Next.
Grace, how do you do e-collar focus? I use tap-tap for healing, so wouldn't tap-tap be confusing for e-collar focus if he's in the heel position?
Not necessarily. You can also mark it with a word if you want to. You can also cheat and go, so you can do that too. Or you can say the dog's name. You can say the dog's name while you're tapping. Next.
Britt, yesterday a little girl tried running next to my German Shepherd. I had to yell at the parent to not let their kid touch my dog. She's 3 inches away. Next time, what should I do?
Push the child away. Oh my God, that's so mean. No, it's not. You'd probably say the child's face. Next.
Debbie, I'm muzzle training my mini bull terrier. It's going well. Cool. However, I can't get him to walk with it on without dragging him along. How do I work past this?
He's not muzzle conditioned yet. So you got to get him to love that. You have to get him to love that muzzle. You got to get him to love that muzzle. So, and then also at the beginning, he's a little bit unmotivated. Just stick to it and be like, let's go, buddy. Come on now. Next.
Debbie, I already read that. Fred, Is it okay to use an e-collar as only a punishment? My dog is acting like the low-level shock is more annoying.
Yeah, absolutely. Next.
Scattered Storm, how long ago did you guys start doing sit stays in your training program?
It's
funny, I actually talked with this with Brittany the other day.
So then answer the question.
I'm like, because it was this time of year, and I remember the dog, and it was Logan, that really dog-aggressive German Shepherd mm-hmm. we had. He was like whiny, like just out of control. We're like, and every time we said sit, he would lie down, and we're like, no, you're going to sit. And I remember, like, I remember the exact
So it's
day.
Been a year.
Probably like a year ago.
A year.
Yep.
So it's been a year. There you go.
Yep.
Thank you, Joelle.
Where am I? Daphne. Hello from Mexico.
Hey, hola.
Good dog coaching and pet care. Getting great traction in building board and train businesses because of posting in-progress training videos on social media.
Awesome.
It's a lot of effort, but well worth it. Thanks for your encouragement to do so.
Cool. It's not a... Well, okay, yes. It is a lot of effort. It's part of doing business in 2019. So doing business in 2019 is putting out massive amounts of free content with no obligation of anything in return. It's putting up start, middle, and end of your training. It's about putting up educational information. It's about doing sound bites. It's about doing blogs if you're good at writing, doing photos, doing videos, putting out massive amounts of content on as many platforms as you can. And guess what? You're right. It's work. Don't automate it and don't freelance it out to other people. That doesn't mean you can't have other people helping you create stuff, but you need to control the narrative because nobody's going to know your business as well as you do. But that's how you do it, all right? And this is so funny. A lot of the hate that comes in on me is like, he's just really good at marketing. It's like, okay, I own a business. Damn fucking right I'm good at marketing. You'd think you would want to be. You're really good at marketing too. You've just marketed yourself as a big asshole, buddy, okay? So I'm marketing myself as a really nice guy, which is just telling the truth. So, but it's called business. That's what business is. I'm a business owner. It's so funny when it's like, I'm not a dog trainer. I'm a business owner who happens to own a dog training company. Yes, I know how to train dogs. I actually travel the world doing dog training seminars, and I'm the one that's doing the work. Joelle is actually really involved right now too with a couple of the different key modules. But the thing is like, I'm a business owner. And as a business owner, you better understand every component. Accounting, right? You got to know about accounting. You got to know about marketing. You got to know about your core business. You got to know about how to manage a staff. So you have human resources. You got to know about legal. You got to know about contracts. You have to know about, it's called business. It's called being smart. And that's who's successful. So I'm going on this rant because there's so many people that are like, he's just good at marketing. Yeah, that's why we're staying busy. That's why we're staying busy. That's why we have so many repeat people. That's why we've got so many dedicated clients that have been with us for years. All right? It's because it's all because of marketing. No. Okay? Everybody responds to marketing. It's so funny. It's like, you know, like it's so funny, the people that hate me on marketing, it's like, do you drive a car? Yeah. Okay, what brand? Great. How'd you find out about that car? Where's the last place you went out to eat? Great. How'd you find out about that? Wonderful. Like everybody responds to marketing. That's how we buy stuff. So instead of criticizing, observe. Mouth closed, eyes and ears open. You'll learn shit. You'll learn shit. So for all the brand new dog trainers out there, remember, success leaves crumbs. Got it? Success leaves secrets. There's no magic to any of this, any successful business. Watch what they do. Observe them. Just observe them. You'll learn. You'll learn what they do. Next.
Woo.
What?
That's some like helpful information.
Yeah, well, of course. And it's free.
And it's free.
And there's no obligation to freaking give me anything in return. Next.
Okay.
And everyone, someone's like going, get to the next dog training question, please. And I'm like, okay.
Alrighty. If you ask, we do it.
You should do these, Paul. These shows.
Awesome. Spuds, what is your magic to stopping the whine? I'm going crazy. It's relationship. Because, you know, as soon as I walk in the building, he starts whining again.
They're not starting the whining.
Yeah. Stopping it is me going away. When I'm away on trips, he doesn't whine for staff either.
He doesn't whine for me either.
It's just like, ugh.
He'll spend 8 hours with me
the
not whining.
The only thing I can get him to stop is if he has a remote collar on.
Right. So remote collar helps. Next. Yeah.
And he knows as soon as I take it off, he's like, I'm going to whine.
Yep.
Next. Thomas, love what I do too. Not taking a vacation in 10 years. Don't miss it for a second. Right. I totally get what you're saying. Also, when you deal with truth, it really does not matter what your haters say or do.
Well, no. Well, first of all, there's a couple things about truth. Okay? It's not easy to be one of the few people out there telling the truth. Truth brings out haters. Okay? You can't handle the truth.
Name that movie.
So name that movie and who said that, all right? Name five other movies.
I think we already did this in one show.
Oh, did you? But name five other movies that person was in. So this is the thing. If you're going to be the one that stands up and tells the truth, there's going to be a lot of people that don't like that. So I open myself up to it, but that's okay. I'm a big boy. I can handle it. I'm a big boy in a world of children out there. Dog trainers are behaving like children. There's so many dog trainers out there right now that are literally behaving like infantile children. It's incredible. It's like grow up. Grow up. You're a schoolyard bully. That's all you are, is a schoolyard bully. Next.
Top Chat 999 from Dino. Had the wheelbarrow out and it freaked my dog out. Troubleshooting with him in a down stay next to it, but he couldn't stay focused or calm. What should I do in similar situations in the future?
Sounds, well, you just might need more time. Put the wheelbarrow out, put your dog into a place, put your dog into a down, leave it there. Or put your dog in a down, start distance away. Next.
Grace, thanks again for all your advice.
You're welcome, Grace.
Levi, Django is a shepherd and husky, two of the whiniest dogs, lol. Woo! Got yourself a screamer.
Next.
Kayla, hey guys, hope you all are well. My dog tends to really get snippy when he knows he's in trouble. Correcting him seems to make him worse. Sometimes keep correcting, or what do I do?
Excuse me. I don't know your skill set. I don't know how you're correcting him. All I know is if my dog got snippy with me, there'd be a pretty hard correction. Like, you don't put your mouth, no dog puts their mouth on me, but my own dogs, they don't put their mouth on me. So, I don't know what you're doing, but also remember, if you're using any emotion, it's going to work against you. Next.
Daphne, I have a 1-year-old Great Dane that is very nervous and dog reactive. When I punish on correction level with the e-collar, it seems to make it worse. What am I doing wrong?
What, dog's nervous?
Yeah, nervous and reactive.
So, okay, it makes it worse, meaning it makes your dog more nervous. I don't know what your timing is, but also that you just might be going through the messy middle. I don't know how long you've been working on it. I got somebody commented on a post today on our YouTube channel saying, I've had my dog for 24 hours, but he doesn't seem to know recall, and he's 10 weeks old. I'm not throwing this person under the bus, but I'm like, you had him for 24 hours? Like, it takes a long time to train recall. Like, what makes you think that he would know recall? So I don't know how long you've been working on this. So dog training so stopping unwanted behavior, that doesn't take much time. Dog training, that can take time. Next.
RC, my 1-year-old Cane Corso constantly has dilated pupils. What's the best way to stop that?
You can probably just take a spoon and pop the eyeballs right out.
Oh my God.
Try that.
There's a sound bite for you.
I don't know. I've never been asked that question. So I would actually talk to a vet and see if there's anything medical. Next.
Colleen, hi Jeff. What training books do you have to any beginner training book recommendations?
That was an AMA.
Yeah. I feel like people ask this every show.
What's the name of Sean? Just go to The Good Dog Way. The Good Dog Way. Love Them by Leading Them. It's a great book. Next.
Katie, I have an Aussie mix that has very thick neck fur. I have the long prongs on her e-collar, but they are still not maintaining contact with her skin. E-collar is snug and properly adjusted. Any advice?
Get the thick fur contact points, and you might have to shave down, not to the skin, but thin out, shave down a little bit of an area on this side of the neck, and that side of the neck. But they're thick fur contact points, which are different than the long contact points. Next.
Levi, can you provide any insight as to what changes we might see or expect with an 11-month-old Cane Corso as she matures?
Usually, sometimes pushiness, snidiness, aggression comes out. Guarding behavior comes out. You see a little bit more of that. Just the way they vocalize, like with their barking, that also can change. A lot of times you see more of people that are like, oh, my dog is so great. And then all of a sudden they're like, fuck, my dog sucks. Holy shit. Where did all these bad behaviors come in? Selective listening. It's not just a Corso. It's just like almost all dogs. Next.
Scattered storm, cool radar did that too, which is a prompt for me to start too. We just started drills again after a really long break.
Good job. What you talking about?
Sit stays,
good.
Downing.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. When you ever have a dog that defaults to a down, do long sit stays.
Nice. You go. My Australian Shepherd is a whining dog only when he is with us.
Yeah, I mean, I think dogs know what they can get away with.
Yeah.
They do.
Sure do.
They sure do. Next.
It's all attention seeking.
Yep.
Cobri, what is the best way to correct my GSD puppy attacking the vacuum cleaner?
Make it suck. Remote collar or bonker, make it suck. Whenever you want to stop a behavior like that, you make it uncomfortable. Remote collar on the dog, turn the vacuum cleaner on, dog attacks the vacuum cleaner, correct the dog at a high enough level that goes, wow, that really sucked. So you can also say no, bonk the dog, that really sucked. Next.
Kayla, my 9-month-old border collie has very severe horses reactivity, barks insanely, and will bite me if I correct. Any tips?
Put a muzzle on the dog and correct. Leash on the dog, correct. Keep the dog away from you. What you're also probably doing is your corrections are too late. The dog's probably also already in drive. What I want you to do is have that dog nice and calm. So this is how I would fix it. You ready? I would take your dog and I would go hunting for horses. I'd find some horses and I'd have your dog on a leash. And the horses would be, say, 100 feet away before your dog's reacting. And then I would just do a sit with your dog. Your dog would sit and I'd have a bonker ready to go. And I show this all the time with my bicycle. Like, look at my bonking video from the bicycles, all right? And then what happens is, as soon as that dog recognizes the horses, I would say no, bonk the dog extremely hard. All of a sudden.
It's the dryer.
Oh, it's the dryer. It's cute. Can you change that? Does that music change? Is it the same song? You can't do like a little, change it from your phone? Not yet, pretty soon. So what I want you to do is then I bonk. No, and then bonk. There you go, next.
Thomas, that business rant was the best.
Oh, I got tons of business rants.
Tons of rants.
I got tons of business rants.
All the rants.
No, it's just funny because, it's so funny because when you start talking about business or you're successful in business, people think you don't care about the dogs.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, he only cares about the money. It's like, no, but I do want to make a lot of money. Yeah, and don't tell me you don't.
But like, what is it you always say? It's a voluntary transaction business. So the more money you make, the more dogs you're helping.
Right.
The more people you're helping.
Right. The more people I can employ.
Right.
The higher rate of salary that I can pay.
I was like, why is money, like making money a bad thing?
Money is neutral.
Right.
Money is neutral.
It exposes people,
yes,
that's for sure.
It sure does. It exposes you a lot. So this is the thing. It's like, but that's a bad thing. It's also based on jealousy.
Yeah.
So poor people tend to give people with money a hard time.
Right.
That's just the way it works.
Yeah.
Everybody wants to make money. Now, money does not equal happiness at all. Right? So money can just buy you a very expensive gun to shove in your mouth and a lot of drugs if you want to. But all I'm saying is money is not bad. And a lot of people have got our prosperity consciousness issues. There's something called prosperity consciousness. Mm-hmm. And it's because they've had bad programming or programming from a young age that money is bad. And that was passed down to them from their parents, their grandparents, teachers, bosses, their friends, that money is bad. Money is not bad. Money is neutral. It is a neutral thing. It sits there. Mm-hmm. Okay? So, but for a lot of these people that are like, you know, it's like, money gets you a lot of things, and it doesn't just buy you material things. It could get you better health care for yourself or for your animal. It could get you moved out of a certain neighborhood so your child has a better school system. It can get you a more reliable car, which will enable you to get to a better job. It doesn't have to be a fancy car, but it can be, instead of the car that keeps breaking down, it can be a newer car, even if it's $140 or $150 a month. You can buy you can buy a new car now for $15,000 to $20,000, which I think is an inexpensive price for a car that's reliable, that can get you to work.
Yep.
So now you don't have to take buses everywhere unless you choose to, but you can actually transport your children around. You can get to a job. You can pick your kids up from school. But people really diss money. It's like money, it's like, forget about Instagram wealth here, guys. Like flashy things. Okay, there's a lot of other things. So, you know, money also can help you build a legacy. Money can also help you do a lot of things. So also people that make a lot of money tend to give a lot of money away.
I'm just going to say that.
Right. So nobody ever talks about the $100,000 in pro bono work I do. Now, the reason why I can do $100,000 a year in pro bono work is because I'm making money. For some reason, that gets missed a lot. So it's interesting, though. It's really, really interesting that people have got this hang up on money. But when it comes to dogs and money, they assume it's one or the other.
Right.
It's like, no. It can be both. It can be both. So we just left Unleash Unlimited in Texas. Our host, he's got a beautiful facility.
Beautiful.
Okay. It's probably not cheap to run. Now, his clients probably love taking their dogs there. It costs money for him to run that. Everything. Literally everything. He needs to make a profit. So I was in his washroom where they have a bathing station. And like, it's funny because you've got bottles of like, what do you guys use, kennel salt? Like bottles of kennel salt, which are the disinfectant. Like it costs a lot of money to run a business. Everything, light bulbs, electricity, there's heat, there's water,
there's staff,
there's like internet access, there's phone lines, there's like you need to make a lot of money. So people see like a $5,000 boarding train, but I assure you, maybe 10% of that ends up in the owner's pocket. So because there's something called expenses, and then there's also something called taxes. So it's interesting. I don't know how we got on that rant, but what I want people to do is a lot of new dog trainers, they get freaked out about the whole money thing. Like, oh my gosh, am I really entitled to be making this money? Like a lot of young dog trainers are making more money than their parents ever did.
Right.
And that freaks them out. Mm-hmm. And then the people that start making a lot of money self-sabotage their businesses. So they actually don't. And people are like, oh, people would never do that. Yes, they do. People that don't feel worthy enough, do that. People also that have self-worth issues also don't have good relationships. Because what happens is when they finally start having a good relationship, they actually don't feel worthy of having a good relationship with somebody. So they do something to self-sabotage that. That also happens. That's why people that struggle, that have been, call it whatever you want, a victim or a survivor of domestic abuse, the pattern keeps happening because of their self-worth issues. So the conversation we should be really having out there and what we should be really teaching in our school systems is fuck all this geography stuff. If I want to know where a certain place is, I'm going to look on my phone.
Yeah.
I look on my phone for everything.
Just ask Angelo.
Okay? I'll look on my phone for anything. How do you spell this? I'll just fucking type it in. My phone will say, no, asshole. It fucking spelled like this. Okay? I actually programmed my phone to say that to me. All right? So, but a lot of people, what they do is you need to be started teaching like self-worth. That's what we need to teach.
Confidence.
Self-awareness. Self-worth. How to be kind. How to be nice. How to be generous. How to give. How to be caring. Those value systems have gone. And that needs to be brought back. Everything else, right here. This is where you can learn it all right here. Next.
Oh, man, some good rants tonight. I knew I'd get you going. How did that even start? My God, what was the question?
I don't know.
That was good. Whoever started that. Let's see. Man, we have a lot of questions.
Oh, well.
D, will a bonk work for stopping our dog from growling, threatening strangers who come into our house?
Yes.
He loves everyone outside the house. I've got the towel locked and loaded.
Yes.
Do I need an e-collar?
Yes. Tie back on your dog. No bonk. Next.
Thomas says, in the end, the truth wins.
Thank you, Thomas. You're right. What's Thomas's last name? Does Thomas have a last name?
Thomas Sandberg.
Oh, he's the author.
Oh, that's Thomas.
That's a raw food guy.
Oh, hey, Thomas.
Isn't it?
I don't know.
I think that is.
You're right, yeah.
I think that is. Go to his thing.
Yeah, I'm looking at his little icon. I think that's it. Long living.
Oh, yeah. Guys, if you want to know about raw food, go, Thomas, put Thomas's info. Thomas, you're allowed to put your information up there, buddy. Love you. Thank you for the ebook. Love your stuff. I started reading it. I'm gonna read more of it on the airplane. Love you. I really do. I appreciate you. Thanks.
Yameli. Hi guys. What are your opinions on emotional support dogs, therapy dogs? Are dogs truly fit to be one?
Dogs are. Not many. I think that.
Don't worry, I'll get him going.
So, sorry. The rest of our host clothes came off, right? So I just thought that funny. So I think, what the fuck was the question? Not a lot of dogs are suitable to become them. I definitely, absolutely do not discount folks with emotional issues. I do feel that we've got a lot of fake ones out there. It's like, oh, it's just your dog and it makes you feel better. But I will not discount the need for them. I think most dogs are not capable of being them though. Next.
Timberwolf logging. Hey Jeff, what do you think I could do about a problem with my German Shepherd? He flank sucks morning and night for hours. Very stressful, especially since I have a traumatic brain injury.
So remote collar can stop any of those OCD behaviors. Next.
Katie, great, thanks. I was wondering if shaving would help. Definitely give it a try.
Yeah, definitely does. Next.
Thomas said the dilated pupils is a sign of mineral deficiency. Get a blood test done.
Awesome. Thank you, Thomas.
Thomas says the more money you make, the more good you can do.
Excellent.
Scattered Storm, the amount of money you make reflects how much stress you can handle.
There's some truth to that. So Scattered Storm, you increasing your prices was a good move.
Your point was synchronized with your cost.
Right. Synchronized coughing.
The people who are listening to this without the visual are probably like, what the hell is going on in that show?
Speaking of, for everybody, I think we're on about 20 different podcast platforms. So for all the folks listening to me, at least, especially, all of them, but we know there's iHeartRadio, Spotify, SoundCloud, all the Google platforms, Apple platforms. Thank you so much for listening to the show. Next.
Kathleen said it once, and I'll say it again. Thank you so much for what you've done for me and my dog. Max has mastered Double Down and has been a game changer.
Awesome.
Hardly ever breaks place and has been more mentally in command. So proud of myself and of him, and thanks to you guys.
Kathleen, love you.
Oh, Kathleen, thank you. Proud of you.
That's good.
She's been showing up for all the pack walks.
Has she?
Yeah.
Good
with
job.
With him in his purple parka.
That's right. You gotta look fashionable on them pack walks.
Gotta look good.
It's fucking cold now in Providence.
Yeah.
It's cold. Guys, we're in Austin,
it's
Texas. Austin, Texas. 28 degrees tonight.
Windy as hell.
When we leave here at, what, 2:45 a.m.? It'll be 28.
I'm going to stay up all night. Get some shit done. I'll sleep on the plane.
Paul's like, we have a rule. We have some rules in this house. And one of them is, nobody gets shit done past 11.
Daphne, I've been working with her for 5 months. I punish when she sees the dog and breathes heavily. She used to lunge at the dog, but now after the correction, she shakes heavily, barks, and shakes.
Yes. So what's probably going on is your dog is trying its best not to display the unwanted behavior, and you're dealing with a messy middle right now. Next.
Kathleen, I already read that. Britt. I was walking on the road for distance. Also, we had workers over, and my German Shepherd was nice and saw people running at night, did not run or bark.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Scattered Storm, your talk on self-sabotaging a business is absolutely real. Definitely something I could be at risk of. I could definitely see myself doing it.
So, Scattered Storm, what I want you to do, Gretchen, is I want you to start listening to a lot of, jump on to Brene Brown, number one. So jump on to Brene Brown, watch her YouTube TED Talk, start there. Then also get Jen Sincero audiobooks, okay? But the all this on YouTube, her TED Talk, start with that. It's 20 minutes. I think it might be 19 minutes and 57 seconds, okay? So start with her TED Talk, and then you can get the audiobooks. And a lot of that stuff is free also on YouTube, okay? Next.
Thomas said, yes, that's me. Thank you. Love to Jeff and Joelle.
Oh, thank you, Thomas.
Jay. Hey, J&J, during a game of tug with my dog, if I say no, he drops it and backs up on his own. Should I change this to the out command?
If you want to, you can. But if no is working, you can leave it alone. But if you want to switch it to out, that's up to you. It's just a word. Next.
Sandra, I was going to tell you, we ordered this cold weather just for your visit, y'all.
Thank you.
Thanks, Sandra.
I don't mind. I got gear.
I didn't bring anything.
Well, I'll tell you what, tomorrow morning, at 2:30,
we're outside for 5 minutes.
I'll heat the truck up.
Cool.
Okay.
Kara, you guys try Whataburger yet? Get a honey butter chicken biscuit. Oh my God.
No.
Only in Texas.
No.
Served till 11 a.m. I'm in Ohio. Wish I could go back for one now.
No. So Joelle and I don't eat crap.
Last night was my first time ever having like real barbecue.
So
I tried it.
So we're not going to go to Whataburger. Okay, we're not going to In-N-Out Burger. So I will tell you, I'm going to piss off a lot of people right now.
Never had In-N-Out either.
I'm going to piss off a lot of people right now. I'm out in Chatsworth, California, my buddy Sean's place. My buddy Ruben, who I love dearly, he's like, we're going to In-N-Out Burger. I said,
everybody talks about it.
I know. I said, okay, what is it? I've heard about it. So he says, oh, you got to do it. They got to actually have a secret menu. So, well, it ain't fucking secret if everybody knows about it, right? So, no, we have a secret menu. So I said, fine, we'll go. So we go, and he gets me a secret burger. All right? I get it. I take one bite, and I go, oh, so it's McDonald's. Now, I just pissed off a lot of people, I know. Yes, I've had McDonald's and Burger King and Wendy's when I was a kid. But I eat healthy now. But I was like, okay, let me try it. Because I will have a Five Guys. You know what I mean? I'll have that. And I'll eat a steak. So, but what I'm saying is, it's like, I don't get it. I don't know where the fuck we went. And I just pissed off a bunch of people, probably for no fucking reason whatsoever. Next.
All over the place tonight.
Next.
Have you seen these memes all over Facebook and Instagram about Jeffrey Epstein? They're everywhere.
Okay.
Everywhere.
So you're trying to get me to go on a rant. Aren't you? You want me to go on an MC rant?
I mean, yeah. There's not that many questions right now.
Okay.
What do you think? What do you think?
What do I think about Epstein?
What do you think?
Okay. You really want to know?
Yeah.
There's two theories that I would believe. First of all, he didn't kill himself.
Okay.
Absolutely did not commit suicide.
Okay.
He was either murdered or he's still alive and in hiding and it was a cover-up. Those are the two things that I believe in.
I feel like that's not even an option. You just like pulled that one right out of the hat. Have people been playing with that theory?
I don't think I'm the first one to come up with that. It's doable. It's like, no, well, this is the deal. You spill the dirt on everybody, we'll fake your death, and you have to just start fucking disclosing information. And you become a government informant. Or he was killed. One of the two. I don't think he killed himself. I believe he was either Murzo. That's it. I'm not going to go on a rant though.
All right.
Because we can go down the hole. We can talk about
the whole rabbit hole.
We can talk about Pizzagate. We can go all the way down all the different things.
I've just been seeing those memes everywhere.
Are they?
Yes. Everywhere.
All right.
Kara, I used to watch It's Me or the Dog on TV when I was younger. I wonder how that became a show. Trainer would tell people to turn and ignore a jumping dog. The bad advice is off the charts. It's scary.
So that became a show by a casting agent looking for actresses. The original hostess of that show was a dog trainer. Okay, was a dog trainer. And she was not as visually pleasing as the current one supposedly is. So she lost the role. Also, if you look at the, you can find all this information. She would, there was a lawsuit because she was not a dog trainer and she was an actress. And they, everybody got wind of it. So, you know, but it's entertainment. It's an entertainment show. That's why you watched it. It was entertaining to you. Next.
You know what show I used to like? The one, the cat guy with like all the mean cats, and he'd come out and like tame them.
I don't know.
You don't know? No. What the heck was that called?
I don't know.
Maybe it was like the cat whisperer.
Maybe.
Spuds, I'm enjoying spicy Jeff and overtired Joelle tonight. That's like the norm.
So it's like, so
spicy.
So you'd like
I
us
to give you my pokey shirt. This is spicy as fuck.
So you'd like us every night then?
Kara, keep poking for a rant, Joelle. I'm trying. Kara said, interesting, there was no funeral or anything.
No.
There's no funeral. Yeah, that is interesting, huh? If he actually is dead, didn't do a funeral?
There could have been a private service.
Yeah. Ooh.
There could have been, guys, you know.
Conspiracies.
There's a lot of conspiracies.
Well.
Next.
There's nothing right now.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Are you really?
Oh, Rotten Roddy said, Whataburger ain't no effing McDonald's.
I didn't say Whataburger. I said In-N-Out
yeah,
Burger.
Yeah, we said In-N-Out.
I said In-N-Out. I said
We've
In-N-Out
never
Burger.
Had Whataburger.
I've never had a Whataburger.
But he is passionate as fuck about Whataburger, so you don't go there.
So don't worry. Who's that?
Rotten Roddy's.
So Rotten Roddy's, man. I'm not looking for Burger Wars, man. Okay, I pick my battles. I'm not looking for a Burger War here. I'm just saying the whole In-N-Out thing, I don't get. But I'm not a fast food guy. It's sort of like saying Star Trek is the best movie ever. I don't like science fiction movies. So I'm not the science fiction guy either. So, it doesn't matter. My opinion of In-N-Out, McDonald's, Burger King, Whataburger, doesn't matter. Because that's not my flavor. That's not my thing. Sushi, I like. Thai food, I like. Indian food, I like.
And I hate all of them except sushi.
Okay. So those are the foods that I like. But I'm just not a fast food person. Next.
Alrighty. Let's see if we can get back on track here. Scatterstorm, I used to watch that show too. Loved it as a kid. Today, it's
Scatterstorm, you are. You're 17.
She's like 17 going on like 30 though.
When I was a kid.
She's very mentally mature.
When I was a kid.
Kim, my cat from hell. Love that show.
Is that what it's called?
These cats are nasty. Couples like a divorce over these cats.
Of course, cats can be I mean, have you ever seen an actual cat fight?
Yeah.
Like seen it, not heard it.
Yes, they're really mean.
I remember the first time I heard one. Like, yeah, cats. But cat fights are nasty.
I know.
Those fuckers are, I mean, they're probably dropping 1,000 punches a minute.
Oh, so
Jesus Christ!
So I used to have this really fat cat when we lived in South Carolina, and we named him Newman, of course, after Seinfeld. Like, he was just like the fat, like, Newman. And
why do you have to be shaming?
He was just like a pain in the ass, just like Newman was on the show.
Right. I didn't think Newman was a pain in the ass.
And he just like, he came in and out as he pleased. And he would always bring us back, like, dead animals. He was a savage. He would, like, bring us baby ducks and stuff. I'm like,
damn.
God. Savage. Cats are not to be trifled with.
Nope.
Ra, or R-A, I guess. He put the dots now. What age do you start to use a prong collar?
Usually you can start at around 12 to 14 weeks old. But you're not using it for punishment, corrections. Using it to get the dog used to wearing it. Next.
Scattered Storm. I don't know what that's about. He's tried to explain before. Oh, cat aggression. Mm. Anyway. Rotten Roddy says, I agree on In-N-Out.
Okay.
Okay, good. So that's cool.
So we're cool, Rotten Roddy? So we're cool? So we're cool?
Don't this Whataburger.
Okay. So
In-N-Out, though.
So you're not going to hunt me down?
Next. Good to know. R.A., what collar should you use for puppies 4 to 6 months?
I use a prong collar. Next.
Tommy, hi J&J, agreed. Whole food is the best.
Yes.
Sure is. Scattered storm. LOL, love how the podcast gets off track in the last half hour after y'all get through the questions and everyone just starts chatting.
It's true. It's so funny because we get so many comments on YouTube. I gotta delete all this shit. People are like, God, all these guys ever do is like just talk. And they don't even answer questions all the time. It's like,
we try at least save this stuff for the end.
But also, it's like, you must be a fucking hit at dinner parties. It's like,
can we stay on topic, please?
It's like, you must be a real hit at dinner parties. It's like, you have got to learn the art of conversation. You have to learn the art of engagement. You have to learn how to hold people's attention. This is an entertainment show or an edutainment show. Call it what you want to. This is not just a Q&A dog training show, even though it is dog training Q&A. But it's bigger than that. It's bigger than that. I mean,
we got a little tribe here.
That's right.
Freaking love our fans.
That's right. We love all of you. Next.
Yep.
So if you love the show, give us a thumbs up. If you don't love the show, okay, Rod and Roddy, if you want to go on and get on my case about Whataburger, give me a thumbs down tonight. Next.
I'm supposed to love you.
Next.
Mary, how do you stop your dog from peeing in the crate?
That could be a challenging one. Number one, make sure the size of the crate. First of all, check for health. Chances are it's not, but it could be a UTI. It could be something else. Monitor its food and water. Also, the size of the crate, make sure it's small. Put your dog on a really good schedule, a bathroom schedule. Actually make an Excel spreadsheet so you can track to make sure you're on topic. Also, make sure you mark the accidents at the time of the accidents to the best of your ability and see if there's a pattern. Next.
Sid, hi J&J. Walking GSD today and saw a nasty neighbor from previous farm property. He slowed his van to tell me I wasn't welcome around here. Haters keep hating. Thanks to you, I don't give a shit.
You're not welcome around here?
God.
My God. Okay. That's interesting. And then you hopefully shot out his tires, right? I mean, it's like, you're not, did he say your kind is not welcome around here?
So rude, the nerve.
You know? You're not welcome around here. Okay. So I'll get off the public streets as soon as possible. It's so,
did you laugh? Like, how did you respond?
It's so funny how, like, people really...
Who was he, this self-appointed neighborhood watch?
It's just so funny how people...
Calling, welcome.
They really
here.
Feel like they matter that much. They're like, oh, okay, I'll stay off this street forever.
Thank God. It's like...
Next.
All these people, like, self-appointed positions. Daphne, thank you. Your videos and podcasts have helped us so much. Good. I was lost before with positive training and couldn't walk my dog when she was 6 months because she's so strong.
Yeah. So there's just to let everybody know, like, be careful about it. So positive training has a huge purpose. That's how we train every dog in obedience. We train every dog in obedience that way. We train every obedience command that way. Mm-hmm. We counter condition aggression that way. We, after we've stopped unwanted behaviors, we train what we want with positive training, reward-based training. Next.
R.A. says, thank you. Love you guys.
You're welcome.
Kara, how could I go about getting into aggression rehab?
I would mentor. I would intern and get a mentor with somebody that actually works it and watch how they do it hands-on. Next.
Rotten Roddy says, love you guys. Thanks for the laughs and content. Oh, thank God. They love us.
Okay, thank you.
I was like scared we were going to get into a heated debate about freaking Whataburger.
Well, we wouldn't get into a
debate. We
wouldn't get into a debate because I control the fucking show.
True.
This is the show's a democracy. I mean,
no,
not
dictatorship.
It's not a democracy. It's a dictatorship.
Yeah. But really, you don't want our opinion on fast food because we're going to say it all sucks.
Yeah, it all sucks because we don't
but eat. But we're going to talk about coffee.
There we go.
Yeah.
Mojo Coffee.
That's good.
Mojo. Did you go to Mojo Coffee? You don't drink coffee.
You don't drink coffee?
But they've got tea there.
Holy shit. Do you drink tea? Drink coffee.
What?
You're a business owner and you don't drink coffee? What do you drink?
But they got smoothies there.
I used to drink a lot of soda.
Soda.
Then went off that and just take caffeine pills.
You take caffeine pills?
Oh! You take caffeine
pills. This is a shortcut. Okay.
Gotta come from
why waste the calories and take straight caffeine?
Right. So, right.
RA says, our dog is amazing because of all your videos.
Oh, that's good to hear. Thank you.
Scattered Storm, when I was a kid, LOL. Feels like forever ago, actually.
Forever ago. Yeah, you probably had to grow up really, really fast, Gretch.
Thomas, first time live. Love it. You two have such great chemistry.
Thank you, Thomas.
John, stay warm. We moved back to Michigan because Texas heat is a bitch, but it does get old as fudge, too. Safe travels.
Yeah.
Cold as fudge.
So, I'm originally from Ohio. I'm originally from Cleveland, well, Lyndhurst, Ohio, but I grew up in the east side of Cleveland. I actually spent a lot of time in Cleveland, 165th and Lorraine, to be exact, which is where my father's drugstore was. So 165th and Lorraine was Cam's Rexall Pharmacy. And I started working there when I was 9 years old, and I was a stock boy. And I used to shine shoes as well there. And that's where I started my career working. And then we used to go downtown Cleveland a lot as teenagers to cause trouble. In fact, we bought our fake ID at the Terminal Tower. I think that's what it was called. And I haven't been back since, but I'm originally from the Midwest. Next. We drove through. We saw my old house.
Yep.
Next.
Mary, would you recommend the use of a correction collar and a prong collar at one time? Would you ever need to use them together?
What's a correction collar? Do you mean a shock collar? Sure. Next.
Sid said, I just shrugged my shoulders like so. I didn't say anything. I chose to rise above him, still being a dick.
Yeah. That's good.
That is good. That's it right now.
Okay. Cool.
Cool.
Got any rants? You all set for Hawaii?
No. I have to pack all my stuff still.
Yeah, that's good. It's not like you gotta pick it out.
I know, but I gotta roll it all up.
Yeah, but
pack it up.
But you don't have to decide what to pack.
No.
It's here.
Yeah, it's here.
Because if you either leave it here or you pack it.
Yeah, but like my stuff's kind of like everywhere.
Is it really?
Because I had to wash my hair last night. I had to blow dry it, curl it. It's a lot of
process. And that involved clothing.
No, okay. I was talking like bathroom stuff.
Oh, toiletries and stuff. Mm. That's easy though. Whatever's in your bathroom, you take.
Yeah, pretty much.
Except for his towels and his soap.
He's like, ah, Joelle, those weren't free gifts.
Those were complimentary towels.
Oh, yeah, he's so great. He gave me the nicest towel.
I can see on the plane tomorrow. We're sitting on the plane. All of a sudden, Joelle pulls out a little soap pump. We got Paul gave out gifts. Who's giving out gifts? I don't even own a home yet, but he gave me a nice housewarming gift. Look at this beautiful soap dispenser.
It'll look great in the new rental. Okay. All right. Here's a new question from Bob. Not correcting obedience, at what age would you start correcting bad behavior? What is the youngest you would use a bonker, e-collar, or leash pop?
Well, at 8 weeks old, if you're being a jerk in the crate, I'll bonk the crate. Next.
That's it.
That's it?
Yep.
All right. You know what? Let's end this show because we got to pack and we got like, a lot of things to do. And I'm coughing a lot.
Coughed more. Right on me. So rude.
Oh, yeah.
He doesn't. He's a rude cough. He doesn't cover his mouth.
I do. I'm really sick.
He's so rude. Yeah, we know. I think spread everywhere. All weekend. I could be in a plane with this guy. I had to work with this guy. Good thing I have a good fucking immune system, man. It's all those oranges.
Good thing I got a high tolerance for complainers.
If I get sick too, you don't want to see sick Joelle. Right? Keep your germs to yourself. Show's over.
All right. What do we got there?
Oh, hold on. We got a few from Kim. How can you help shelter dogs if they don't allow you to use tools? Sorry if you answered, phone loss connection.
You don't. You don't help them. So you go into the shelter. This is it. Shelters need to wake up. Okay? Whatever you guys are doing in shelters, the concept of shelters or this concept of dog shelters being like you have to only train with positive methods only, and then writing that into their adoption contract is the biggest. It's such a terrible thing to tell dog owners. Because dog owners are actually trying to abide by that and they're left struggling. The whole shelter system in the United States needs to be revamped. It needs to be totally revamped. So you don't, but you don't. You spend more time keeping dogs out of shelters than you do working in shelters. That's what you do. So I don't go into shelters. Nope. Because they put limitations on everything. I'm not interested in that. You want the dog helped or not. All right, next.
Scattered Storm, yeah, high school has been a roller coaster. I'd say you'd never recognize 14-year-old me, but you two probably see right through my whole charade.
Yes.
Sure do.
Gretch, I got you pegged. You're not that difficult to figure out, Gretch.
Nope.
Not that difficult at all.
Kim, already read that. Scattered Storm said, much happier with myself today.
Awesome. Proud of you, hon.
Cindy, hi, Jeff. Thank you for your videos. I'm starting to train and socialize my overprotective and skittish dog. I'm excited to see how far she'll be able to go.
Awesome. Yeah, you never know. You never know what, like, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years can get you when you stick to it. Next.
Jacqueline, what do you say to a statement that prong collars and e-collar means you don't have a trusting relationship with your dog?
I think that's an ignorant, stupid, fucking ass statement. That's what I think. That's hugely stupid. What does one have to do with another? You don't have a trusting relationship with your dog because you use a remote collar? That's a ridiculous statement.
Tools help build trust.
Tools help build incredible trust.
A dog
trust.
You're just gonna let it off leash? I don't trust you.
My God.
Of course.
Do people actually know what dogs do when they're not on a leash? A lot of them will just run away.
I was gonna say, how many of us know that person when they open the door, the dog just flies up and runs away?
It's like, oh, if you had a better relationship with your dog, you wouldn't do that. It's like, no. You actually don't need a relationship with your dog to have a good recall either.
Right.
It's such a ridiculous statement. That shaming statement is just false, and it's more propaganda by folks that are against tools who have actually no idea what a trained dog is in the real world, or they have no empathy for anybody that's struggling. And that's what it really boils down to. What it really boils down to is the lack of empathy that people have. Just because they might not need something. Well, first of all, what can their dog do? Most people can't take their dogs off leash hiking in the woods past deer. They can't. Why not? So most people can't take their dogs off leash anywhere. Trust and a good relationship have nothing to do with tools. So that means that people that don't use those tools have a good relationship with your dog. That's got to be even a bigger fucking lie.
Mm-hmm.
So many people that don't use tools have got a horrific relationship with their dog. It's not connected. It's a stupid statement. Stupid statement. All right, guys. Mm-hmm. We're out of here.
Alrighty.
All right. Madly in love with you. We got to go. Do we have more questions, though? Should we stay on there?
Maybe a couple.
Yeah, let's stay up. Thomas, I am. Thomas, I'm taking the colloidal silver. Swigging that shit like it was cough syrup.
Yeah.
I'm not. I'm doing the droppers in the mouth. I found some. What else do we got?
Kara says, how come more people don't sell dogs taken from shelters and trained?
One more time.
How come more people don't sell dogs that are taken from shelters and trained?
You'd be surprised. We have actually pulled dogs from shelters, fully trained, and tried to adopt them out. People didn't want them. They didn't want them. They wanted out-of-control dogs because they felt bad for them. Next.
All of the little things. It just started snowing where I live, and my husky spends all of her time eating it instead of going potty when she normally does so on command. Now potty's in her crate and won't stop eating snow. What would Jeff do?
Oh, really?
Oh, my Lord.
Wow. I take that dog out on a leash and don't let that dog's mouth hit the ground and correct that dog for eating snow. But snow eating is not bad. But also, keep your dog, maybe your dog's got to stay out a little bit longer. Next.
My dogs do that too. Yep. They love to eat snow. Scattered Storm, well, yes, but I was so insecure and terrified that you guys seeing right through me would have sent me running with my tail tucked.
But Gretchen, hon, this is it. Of course I see you. I see the real you, hon. Okay? But you're a nice, kind person, and we're all a little bit fucked up, and we all struggle. All of us are struggling. I struggle. We all struggle. I'm 53 years old, and I struggle. I've been working on my shit for 53 years. I shouldn't say that. I've only been working on my shit for
out of the womb.
Okay, for a few years, actually. All right? I didn't think I had to work on my shit. I didn't understand what working on my shit actually meant. And I've said this before about you. You are more self-aware than most 17-year-olds that I know.
Yeah.
Probably any 17-year-old that I know.
Yeah.
You are more self-aware. Okay? But, like, a lot of people are not even self-aware. They're living in denial. They don't take responsibility. They play the victim card. There's a lot of people out there playing victims. So, but we're always working on our stuff. And folks like myself who want to be, have got huge, huge goals in life and want big success for themselves and the people around them are always trying to better themselves. Always. So tomorrow I want to be better than today, especially health-wise. The day after that, I want to be better. And then next week, I want to be better. The next year, I want to be better. Because the better I am, the better the people around me can be. The better I am, the more knowledge that I can share. And I can help change the world the way I want to change the world. So we're all a work in progress. It's never over. So remember that. Always remember that. Okay? Next.
Damn. Michelle said, awesome show tonight. Safe travels.
Thanks. Yeah, we're about to close out the show, guys.
Canadian girl, they sure do. Go trust. Got my dog's e-collar out and he went crazy with excitement.
Of course they do.
Janice, I have a dog that is scared of loud noises. We are going RVing in 7 months. We are working to keep her calm around loud things. Any advice on starting this?
Yeah, I mean, just teach that dog place or down. Correct for breaking the command, start introducing distractions and get the dog, get the dog used to it. I would also probably try to make sure you off-leash train that dog.
Last one from Bob. When traveling in your RV, do you still prepare and feed raw or use dehydrated or freeze-dried raw or go for
In the RV, I've got a freezer and a refrigerator. So I feed, what I do is each one of my dogs eats 2 pounds of raw a day approximately. So what I do is I do meal prep. So I usually prepare it, I always prepare it at home, put it into plastic bags, and then I freeze it at home, and then I put it into the RV, and then I've got food for them, for they each get a bag a day.
So that, I think, like, the last trip we took, we fit all the dog food, like, no problem. It was short, though.
It was a short trip. It was just Sharon Spring.
Yeah.
If we took a 12-day trip with all 5 dogs,
We'd need
a couple Yeti coolers. Yep. Or if we went to someone's facility that we can do food prep at. But that'd be a pain in the ass.
Pain in the ass.
Yeah, we're better off just packing coolers. RV's got big enough basement. Yeah. All right, guys. That's now it. We're going. We're out of here. Madly in love with you. I'm Jeff. This is Joelle. Take care. Love
Good
you
night.
All. Bye.